Welcome to ProPractice, your guide to refine, enliven, and illuminate the piano repertoire. I'm Josh Wright, and today's episode is part of the new technique series where we go through scales, arpeggios, triads, and 7th chords of all the keys on the piano. And each video that I present will have a different practice technique. So if you're working on F-sharp major or something, or F-sharp minor or G-flat major, you will have a different technique than today what I'm going to do for G major and G minor. Last scale was C major and C minor, and I'm just going to go around the circle of fifths. So basically we go up a fifth from C, so we're going to go up to G, and today I will present arpeggios first, since I presented scales first last time. So the unique technique that we're going to do today is finger staccato. Now, there's a lot of benefits to finger staccato. Basically, there's three types of staccatos in pianos, in piano technique. There's finger staccato, where you don't move your hand at all. You just move your fingers. There's wrist staccato, where your wrist does most of the bouncing. And then there's arm staccato, which you can use very seldomly, but you can use it for like big octave sections, like, you know, if you're playing Liszt Hungarian Rhapsody, you might want, you basically lock this, not lock in a bad way, but you just keep it stable, and then you get most of your power from the elbow. So those are the three types of staccatos. Today we're going to focus on just finger staccato, okay? So let's just try G major, and I still want you to think about what we talked about in C major, the C major video, about kind of letting your hand be like a squid as you do this. I don't want you to be jumping from positions because that will set you up for failure. So, see, and you can probably see it better on the overhead camera up here, but you can see how my wrist kind of comes around like that. And what you're thinking of is like you're plucking a guitar string, and you want to be thinking, you want to have like a point of like grippiness, like if you think of like a, you're holding a tennis racket or something, you can feel the grip of it, or a golf club. You want to be able to kind of grip it and then let go. It's not like this sliding off wimpy thing. So you really grip it and pull back. Okay, let's do it again. Let's do four full octaves. Okay, 1, 2, 3 is your fingering. G, B, D are your notes. Left hand. Now with this, again, the same issue as C major. A lot of people think 5-4-2-1 is better. A lot of people think 5-3-2-1 is better. It's up to you. I like 5-4-2-1 because it keeps my hand a little bit more relaxed in these positions. 3-2-1 kind of inverts it that way a little bit. So that's why I like 4-2-1. Keeps you a little bit more straight on. But again, it's up to you. Let's try it. And you're focusing on getting at least mezzo forte sound. Easy to do this like and just get pianissimo, so really strong fingers. And what the purpose of this whole exercise is to teach us to activate our fingers in music. If you've ever heard someone play something like this Chopin etude, and it's just sloppy like that rather than finger staccato is a great place to start because it gets your fingers moving extra, so when you minimize that motion, they're still active rather than being lazy. Okay, let's try hands together. Sorry. Just for fun, let's do a crescendo up and a diminuendo down. One thing that you want to remember is your forte staccatos are just as short as your piano staccatos. A lot of people, as they get lighter, they'll get shorter. Try to keep them all consistent. All right, let's do G minor arpeggio. So we just, for the arpeggios in minor, all we do is we lower the third a half step. So G, B, D to G, B flat, D. Okay, this might be beginning stuff for some of you. This might be common knowledge, but it's always good to review. And if anything, it'll help you prepare to know how to teach. I've noticed that teaching is an art form unto itself. You could be a great player, but have no idea how to teach, and vice versa. I've seen a lot of wonderful professors that really aren't the greatest performers. And I want to help you through this series. Mostly, obviously, it's for your own personal performance. But if you're a teacher and you're wanting to learn different teaching techniques, these can really help your students as well. I've noticed them help my students a lot, and they've been given to me in my own lessons before in various situations. So let's try left hand now. And you know what? Let's see. Yeah, I still like 5-4-2-1 in the left hand. Sometimes it's easy to slip off of the black keys. If one of these students from Juilliard who had studied with this teacher, she was like the most perfect player I'd ever heard. My gosh, she could play like the whole round at the National Chopin was basically perfect. And she said, oh, one thing that I like to focus on is playing on the exact center of every key. So one image that I like to give students is think of a long pin or needle coming out of the end of your finger. And then think of a hole right in the middle of the key that's infinitely small, and it's exactly in the center of the key. And the pin is coming out of the exact center of your finger, and you want that pin to line up and just go down and stab the key right there. Okay, so that will help you to not slip off, because even if you're... That's really easy to slip off. So if you think of being exact center of the key and you can feel the flesh of your finger on the black part of the key. Also, this is basic stuff, but make sure your fingernails are cut short. You don't want to see hardly any white on your fingernails. Obviously, you don't want to cut them so short that they bleed or anything, but you want them short enough to where the flesh part of your fingertip can always be felt on the key. Okay, so let's try hands together now. Let's just try them smooth. Again, these are practice techniques, and now let's try this the arpeggio smooth. What I'm thinking of is relaxed back. I've got an S curve in my back, so my back is a little bit curved right here, so I have good posture, but relaxed. I don't want you to be like sitting like that. Shoulders down, arms hanging loosely. So this technique today that we went over is going to help you get into those higher speeds, because at those higher speeds, really, you're doing a lot of basically finger staccato. So if I was to slow it down, my fingers would actually be doing something like that. They're just on the keys for a little tiny second. I noticed that's one of the great speed inhibitors for a lot of students, is they say, I can't get any faster, but they're playing with heavy, so connected fingers that they don't actually loosen up to the point where they can achieve these higher speeds. So, and you don't even need that kind of speed right there for most any piece. The only thing I can think of is like maybe Ocean Etude, but that's a totally different type of octave or arpeggio technique. All right. Okay, let's move on. Let's go to... Thank you so much for watching. As with all ProPractice videos, the first section is free. If you'd like to view the rest of this video, or if you'd like to learn more about ProPractice, just click on the link on this screen or on the link in the comments section below. Also, if you could like this video, share it, or leave a comment below so it can be shared with as many people as possible, I would truly appreciate it. Thank you so much for your support of ProPractice.